If you like to talk to tomatoes, if a squash can make you smile, if you like to waltz with potatoes up and down the produce aisle. Have we got a show for you? Celery, gotta be
VeggieTales.
Lima beans, collard greens, peachy keen,
VeggieTales.
Cauliflower, sweet and sour, half an hour,
VeggieTales. There's never a rare show like VeggieTales. There's never a rare show like VeggieTales. It's time for VeggieTales.
Hi, this is Larry the Cucumber, and you're listening to the story of King George and the Ducky.
Once upon a time, there lived a king. Like other kings, he had a really neat castle to live in and a lovely little kingdom to rule. But unlike other kings, this king spent most of his time in the bathtub. Oh yes, his name was George. King George. King George, Your Highness, do you think you'll be coming out anytime soon? We have important business to discuss.
What do you think, Ducky? Oh, I couldn't agree more. Not right now, Lewis. We're not finished with our royal bath.
It's quite important, sir.
Oh, Ducky, why can't they just leave us alone?
Yes, it was a little odd. You see, the kingdom was at war. The Great Pie War, to be exact. Usually, when a kingdom was at war, the king would, help. King George loved to take baths, but most of all, King George loved his rubber ducky.
Some kings love horses, and some kings love cattle. Some kings love leading their troops into battle. But me, I'm not like that. I find that stuff yucky. I'd much rather stay in my tub with my ducky. Because I love my duck.
Sir, if I could have a minute.
Love my duck.
There are some things we must discuss.
I love my duck.
See, there's a war and, well, we're in it.
Love my duck.
Though I don't mean to make a fuss.
Then don't. Sing with me, Lewis.
Huh? Oh, okay. Because he loves his duck.
And that is why I can't be bothered.
Loves his duck.
With the particulars of war.
He loves his duck.
Cause quite unlike my dear old father.
Loves his duck.
I find it all a bore. Now concentrate, dear Lewis, and I think you will agree. The most important person in the whole wide world is me. So please don't drag me down with all the people and their troubles. Go run some water in my tub to freshen up my bubbles.
Oh boy.
Because I love my duck.
I don't know why I even bother.
Love my duck.
You just can't reason with this guy.
Because I love my duck.
It's time to face the facts. I think we're all a little stuck.
So let the army run amok.
I fear the kingdom's out of luck.
Because I love my duck.
Yes, undoubtedly we're stuck.
So let the army run amok.
Oh boy, we're really
You're my very favorite toy. Because I love my duck.
It's beautiful. I want it.
What? The house?
No, the ducky.
Oh, but you already have a ducky.
What are you saying? That I shouldn't have whatever I want?
Well...
I must have it, I must get it, you must go and get it for me. If you want me to be happy, then you'll show me you adore me. Don't rest another minute till it's sitting here before me. If you wanna do your best, I would suggest you go and bring me back that duck.
But, sir, if I could just jog your memory, you already have quite a few duckies.
Those are yesterday's duckies.
Huh? Well, these are all perfectly good duckies. Why, most of your loyal subjects would love to have even one ducky this nice.
I don't like these, I don't eat these, I don't want these any longer. My affection for those duckies isn't getting any stronger. To say I can't have what I want, you couldn't be more wronger. Don't ask me to explain, there will be pain if you don't go and get that duck. Our conversation is over.
Did you say wronger?
What? I don't know. Perhaps.
It's more wrong, not more wronger.
It had to rhyme. Don't question a king's grammar. Now go and get that duck.
But King George, we can't just barge in and take Thomas's duck.
Why not?
Well, he'll tell people, and then everyone will think you're gonna come in and take their stuff. You can't run a kingdom that way.
No, all right. Well, then we'll have to do something about Thomas.
What?
Come in! Ah, Frederick! My favorite general! How goes the war?
As Lewis has told you, the Pie War has grown ferocious! We need more men at the front.
Lewis didn't tell me that.
I was trying to, but you wouldn't come out of the...
More men, eh?
Yes, we need more men.
You know, I believe Thomas would like to help.
Thomas? He's rather small.
He's surprisingly strong for his size.
As you wish, sire. Your Highness!
And one more thing, Cedric. Put Thomas at the front of the battle. Then have everyone else step back.
But he'll be creamed!
Your king has spoken.
As you wish, sire.
Lewis, meet me at dusk at the east gate. We've got a little job to do.
It was terrible. Lewis didn't want Thomas to get hurt, and he certainly didn't want to take his ducky, but he also didn't want King George to send him to the Pie War, too. So he did what the king asked.
All right, follow me, and try to act inconspicuous. Did it! Oh, now I'm happy!
Let's have a look at it.
It looks just like your other duckies.
What? Hold your tongue, Infidel! This is the most perfect ducky the world has ever known! It's time for a bath! Who could that be? Come in!
Thomas!
Yes, Thomas! Back so soon?
It was astounding! There he was, alone at the front line! But he never gave up! He stood his ground, and this little fellow single-handedly stopped the advancing horde!
He did?
He's a war hero, sire!
Yes. Well, Thomas,
Incoming! Boysenberry at 3 o'clock!
I'm sorry.
I'm afraid he's lost his mind, sire. The trauma of war.
Oh, no. Well, how long will he be like this?
No telling. Perhaps the rest of his life.
Yeah?
Cobbler in the hole! Hit the deck!
Well, we will give him the highest honor of the kingdom.
Yes, sire. If he were conscious, I'm sure he would thank you. I'll take him to his room now.
Thank you, Cedric. Now, finally, I can take that bath.
Oh, I feel just terrible.
Oh, that's all right. I still have time for my bath.
What? Are you the only one you think about?
No. I've been thinking about this ducky for quite some time now. Since Thomas has lost his marbles, he won't be needing it. So, come on, help me out with that bath. Oh, great. Come in.
I did.
I see. And who are you?
You remember me. I am Melvin, that slightly odd wise man who shows up every so often to tell you things.
Ah, yes. Well, what is it?
I have to tell you a little story.
Not now. I'm gonna go take a bath. Come back at bedtime.
It's important.
Oh, okay. What's that?
It's a flannel graph to illustrate.
Ooh, flannel graph.
There once was a man, a very rich man. He had a lot of sheep. He had a lot of land. He threw a lot of parties. He was dapper, he was tan. Yes, there once was a very rich man.
Okay, great story. I'll see you next time.
Wait just a minute. My story isn't done. It's about two men, and I've only mentioned one.
Oh.
There once was a man, a very poor man. He had next to nothing, just a little lamb. But he loved it like a son, and he fed it from his hand. Yes, there once was a very poor man. Then one day, there was a guest at the house of the rich man. What did he do? Have you guessed to feed the guest of the rich man?
Well, let's see. He had plenty of sheep, so he could just share one of his sheep. Not a problem.
He took the lamb of the poor man. He took the lamb of the poor man. The rich man took to feed his guest the very, very poor man's lamb.
What? Is this a true story?
As surely as I stand before you today, my story is true.
Who is that man? Tell me. To take the lamb of the poor man. When he had lots of sheep of the poor man, only had one. Man! For his cruelty, he will spend the rest of his days locked in my dungeon. Who is he?
Oh, King George, you are that man.
What?
You are the king. You have many duckies. But Thomas only had one, and he loved it very much. But you weren't thinking about Thomas. You were only thinking about yourself and what you wanted.
But I...
Your Highness, what you have done has made God very unhappy. For whether you are a king or just a kid, God wants us all to think of others first. You have been selfish, King George. And when we are selfish, we hurt the people around us, just as you have hurt Thomas. God wants us to love our neighbors, not hurt them.
What do I do? What do I do?
Here is what you must do. Ask God to forgive you. Ask Thomas to forgive you. And then...
Yes?
Make it right.
Well, King George knew exactly what to do.
Lewis, draw a bath!
What?
Trust me.
Okay.
I gotta find Thomas.
He figured a nice hot bath in the royal tub would help Thomas.
Hello. Here, let's clean you up a little.
And sure enough, he was right.
Hey, where am I? Wow, big tub. Am I in heaven?
No, silly. It's just my bathtub. I've got something for you.
My ducky!
King George told Thomas what he had done and asked Thomas if he could forgive him. After thinking it over a bit, Thomas said yes. Then King George prayed and asked God to forgive him too. Yes, sir, being forgiven felt really great. And the people he had hurt, Thomas and even Lewis, by making him do things Lewis knew were wrong, felt much better once they knew King George was really sorry. Yep, it was a happy day.
So, King George, what'd you learn today?
What I learned? Let me tell you. Today, I learned that being selfish doesn't pay. I tried it just the other day. I wanted to be happy. I thought it was the way, but it weren't.
I think you mean wasn't. It wasn't the way.
Well, now I know just what to do. Before I think about me, I better think about you. So send a message out to every boy and girl. There's no better way to make a really yucky world than being selfish.
Selfish. Ooh.
It doesn't pay. I tried it.
You tried it.
I wanted to be happy.
You thought it was the way,
but it weren't.
Weren't.
Wait a minute.
No, it weren't.
Wasn't.
It
should be.
No, it weren't.
King George.
Wasn't.
No, it weren't.
Wasn't. Not.
No, it weren't.
Wasn't.
You're listening to the story of Esther, the girl who became queen.
This is the story of a great person. It's hard to say whether our hero was born that way or was just placed in the right place at the right time and decided to do the right thing. I suppose you can be the judge of that. Oh, and one more thing. Our hero isn't a king, just an ordinary girl.
Esther,
Yeah, Cousin Mordecai?
How long have I been your cousin?
Well, pretty much forever.
Eh, give or take. Have I ever steered you wrong?
Well, no, I guess.
You never need to be afraid to do what's right. Do you remember that song your grandmother used to sing?
You mean the one about God being on our side and not having to be afraid? Yeah, I remember that one.
Good.
But what if she doesn't want to be my friend anymore?
Oh, Essie, you can do the right thing. And there are problems out there a lot bigger than stolen apples. Like that one! It's Haven. That guy hates me. I gotta get scared.
For reasons that do not concern you, in need of a new queen. So, I would like to ask all eligible young ladies to please come with me. A young lady, that means you.
If it's all the same to the king, I think I'd rather stay right here.
I did not ask you if you were interested. The king needs a queen. Get in the wagon.
Essie, for your own good, you should probably go.
What? But I... Sir, I need to stay here so I can take care of my...
Shh! Did you shush me?
What? No, I was shushing...
Hey, I know you. You're Mordecai.
Hello, Haman.
You can call me sir. You know, we both work for the king, but compared to me, you are a gnat.
It's a G. Silent. It's gnat.
Are you calling me a gnat?
No, just correcting your pronunciation.
Are you calling me stupid?
No.
You, get in the wagon. You, bow to me.
No.
Bow.
No.
Bow.
I bow to no one except my God and my king.
Get in the wagon.
But I want to stay with my...
Did you shush me again?
No. Hurry. Essie, go. I'll explain later. Essie, are you there?
Cousin Mordecai? Mordecai, what's going...
Shh! Okay, okay. Sorry about all the shushing. But look, Haman hates us. Hates our whole family. If he knew I was your cousin, he'd hate you too. And then you could be in grave danger. Esther, you mustn't let anyone here know that you're part of our family.
But I don't even want to be here. Why do I have to be here?
Oh, Essie, I don't know the future, but God does. Maybe there's a reason. I'll come visit you again.
Tell me why I don't understand. Tell me why, or show me your hand. Tell me why, because I can't see my way through. What now should I do?
To do again?
A song. You're supposed to sing a song. Didn't you prepare anything?
I guess I wasn't expecting to get this far.
Well, please sing something. You're making me look bad.
see. Okay, I've got something.
The battle is not ours. We look to God above, for He will guide us safely through and guard us with His love. So do not be
I just heard the news! You're the queen of all... Persia.
Yep.
Well, you gotta be at least a little excited.
Nobody even asked me if I wanted to be queen.
Oh, Essie. You always did have a mind of your own. I always liked that about you. Oh, don't worry. There must be a reason. But hey, tomorrow you'll be introduced to the court! Oi, that'll be fun! So, oh, get some rest, Queen Essie. My cousin, Queen of Persia! Who knew?
Mordecai, the king, what's he like?
Oh, he's sharp, real sharp. I think you're really gonna like him.
Do you think she's gonna like me?
Oh, you bet she will. You're the king. Everybody likes you, under penalty of death.
Well, yeah, but, you know, even if I weren't the king, say I was one of those guys who cleans up after the camels, or a lawyer or something, do you still think?
No doubt about it. You're big and strong, charming, handsome. Why, any girl in the whole kingdom would be happy to make you a sandwich. King or no king?
You really think so?
Oh, I know so.
Well, all right then. Bring her in. Her!
Hello, King!
Who are you?
I am Big Fan, your royal chef.
Well, what are you doing here? I don't remember inviting...
Every newlywed needs a cake, no?
Oh, my. Well, that's lovely. You made that for me?
Oui.
Oh, you shouldn't have. It looks delicious. Why don't you bring me over a piece?
Well, you know, I was thinking you could come over here to eat it.
Well, I always eat right here on my throne. Why would I need to come over?
Oh, King, it's delayed. The light in this particular spot is just right. You can only appreciate the full beauty of this confectionery masterpiece in their proper light.
Ooh, light, huh? Well, that makes sense, I guess. I suppose I could come over there.
Hey, who's this guy?
I am the royal chef.
I've never seen you.
I'm, new.
He made me a cake. Psst, isn't that nice?
Did you invite him?
Hey, no.
Did you tell him what can happen to someone who appears before you uninvited?
Well, no. I was too busy thinking about that cake. Doesn't it look yummy?
Stop! It's a trap!
Why is there a piano on my cake?
aren't you the Peony brothers? The most wanted peas in Persia?
That's right, we are!
And we could have taken over the kingdom if it wasn't for that meddling queen!
You saved my life!
Well, actually, Your Highness, it was the good guard Mordecai. He alerted me. It was Mordecai who saved your life.
Oh, well, Mordecai,
King! What should the punishment be for these two dangerous criminals? The most wanted bees in Persia, who appeared before you uninvited and tried to drop a piano on your head!
Well, let's see. It should probably be pretty stiff, huh? What do you think?
I say the punishment should be banishment to the island of perpetual tickling!
You don't mean the island where you are tickled day and night?
Night and day!
Without stop?
Not even if you say pretty please!
There are two things you don't do in Persia. One of them is trying to drop a piano on a king's head. The other is appearing before him uninvited. The Peony brothers found these things out the hard way. Now, it might seem that things are going pretty well for Esther and Mordecai. After all, they saved the king's life. But Haman had something else up his sleeve, or wherever. You see, nothing could be worse for Haman than for his enemy Mordecai to be on a king's good side. If the king liked Mordecai more than him, it might jeopardize his position as the second in command. So Haman came up with his own sneaky little plan.
Your Highness, I believe there is much to fear.
Really? Those peonies are no longer here.
A much greater danger may await you now.
How's that possible?
With permission, Your Highness, I'll tell you how.
Go on.
It's my duty to inform you, and if I'm correct, to ignore this grave emergency would be neglect. It's the motto of my office, serve and protect. There are those who walk among us who show no respect.
Really?
The law must be adjusted. There are those who can't be trusted.
Oh my goodness. Tell me about these people.
A sneaky little family who do sneaky little things, who stick their sneaky noses into matters of the king. I fear if they're not dealt with, the prospect makes me weep. A zucchini-shaped sarcophagus is where you'll sleep.
Really? The nerve! I am disgusted.
There are those who can't be trusted.
That sure doesn't sound like a nice family.
Nope. Your Highness, I believe we must act with speed.
Agreed. Say the word. I'll give you what you need.
A simple solution, but you must act now.
Well, how can I help?
With permission, Your Highness, I'll tell you how.
Go on.
After careful calculation, I've got just a thing. We'll send them to the dreaded Isle of Tickling. But before I can take action, we have to close the deal. And it needs a kingly imprint of your royal seal.
I agree! They must be busted.
There are those who can't be trusted.
That sneaky little family who do sneaky little things, who stick their sneaky noses into matters of the king, for crimes against the kingdom, their punishment is escape. The isle of endless tickling is where they'll sleep.
The law is now adjusted
for those who can't be trusted.
Thank you.
Izzy!
Cousin Mordecai? What is it?
Oh, he's done it! He's finally done it!
Who? Done what?
Look!
What's this?
It's an edict. In just a few days, all of us, our whole family, will be sent to the island of perpetual tickling!
What? Who did this?
Oh, who do you think? Haman! I told you, he hates us! Hates our whole family! And now he's done it! He got the king to sign this! And we'll all be banished!
Oh, what are you gonna do?
That's just it! I can't do anything! I'm just a guard! But you're the queen!
What do you mean?
You must go to him! You must go to the king!
What? Don't you know what happens to people who appear before the king uninvited?
Esther!
Remember the Peony brothers?
Esther! There is no other way! You are the only one who can stop this!
No! No, I'm not gonna! I didn't even want to be the queen! No! You're smart, Mordecai. Think of another way.
Esther, there is no other way.
I wasn't even brave enough to go to my friend about the apple, and now you want me to go to the king? Even if he doesn't banish me for showing up, why would he listen to me? I mean, Haman is his right-hand man.
I can't tell you what to do, but I can tell you this. You wanted to know why you were here, why you became queen. I told you God must have a reason. Esther, perhaps he put you here for such a time as this. Perhaps this is the reason. Esther, you never have to be afraid to do what's right. I'll pray for you. We'll all pray for you.
Tell me why I don't understand. Tell me why, or show me your hand. Tell me why, because I can't see my way through. What now should I do?
Another one of them wise guys once said that in the moment of truth, a great person doesn't have to think much about what they're gonna say or do. They just speak and do what's right. Esther knew what she had to do was right. So she figured she didn't have to be nervous. All right, so she was a little nervous. Give her a break.
Sir?
so we're all set. I got the big boat reserved for Friday. 2 more days, and we'll be rid of that dangerous family forever.
Good work, Haman. What would I do without you?
Hey, who invited the queen? Did you invite the queen?
No. I don't think I did. But that's okay. Come on over here, Queenie Pooh. I don't know if anybody told you, but popping up uninvited is generally discouraged around here.
By death or banishment.
But my little Queenie Pooh can visit me anytime she wants. So what is it you want? Just tell me. Whatever you want, it's yours.
If it pleases the king, there's something that I'd like to... I'd like you and Haman to come to dinner tonight.
Oh, isn't that nice? She's inviting us over for dinner.
Mm-hmm.
You bet. We'd love to come. What time you want us over?
Say 8?
8 it is.
See you then.
Oh, that's nice.
Yep. She's a keeper.
Now, don't get me wrong. Showing up uninvited before His Highness is a very brave thing to do. But telling the king that his right-hand man is a weasel is especially difficult. What if he doesn't believe her? If the weasel stays, well, let's just say it wouldn't be so hot for our girl. No, Esther was looking for just the right moment to spring the news on him.
The real reason I asked you over tonight was to... To see if you would both like to join me for dinner again tomorrow night.
Well, sure!
Oh, yeah!
Yeah, that sounds
well,
great!
I'd love to come!
Are you sure it wasn't Tito?
Nope, not Tito. Well, hello there. I guess there's not much to say, eh, Mordecai? Seeing how in 2 days you'll be waking up in Chuckle City. You know, I just came from dinner with the king and queen, and they invited me over again tomorrow night. I guess they must like me. Why don't you like me, Mordecai? You know, it wouldn't be too hard to show me that you like me. Just a little bow, that's all. Is that so hard? Who knows? I'm a very influential guy. I might be able to work something out for you and your family.
Arrogance is not fitting for a fool, Haman. Much less is lying fitting for a right-hand man. I'll never bow to you.
Oh, yeah? Well, maybe this foolish right-hand man can arrange for you to take your trip to Tickle Town tonight! King, I have a most urgent request. I'm wondering if you
can... Whoa, wait a minute there, Haman. Let me ask you something. I need a little creative advice.
Okay. What is it?
Okay, there's this really great guy that I really want to thank. You know, show him my appreciation for something he did. You got any ideas?
Oh, well, King, I'm flattered.
I was thinking of a card or something.
Oh, no. Cards are nice, but this sounds like a very special guy.
Uh-huh.
It sounds like the kind of guy who deserves a parade.
A parade?
Yeah, I think this guy should be dressed in royal robes and be marched through the whole city on your horse. And maybe you should even let him wear one of your crowns.
Well, I guess he is pretty special.
And one of your most noble princes should lead this man through the streets, proclaiming, "This is a really neat guy, the king!"
king really likes him. He's brave and has rugged good looks.
You see, Haman, you're the creative one around here. What would I do without you?
Oh, well, you know, thank you, Your Highness.
All those things you mentioned, every last one, do that for the good God Mordecai, the man who saved my life. And you be the one to go with him on that parade, okay? I knew I could count on you. Lucky thing you dropped by. Now, what was it you wanted? You know, maybe you should just ask me tomorrow. I'm getting kind of sleepy. Good night!
They say that pride comes before a fall. It looks like nobody told that to Haman. But if Mordecai, Esther, and their whole family are going to be saved, Esther's got to come through. And she's only got one more chance.
See ya, Haman! Thanks for the parade!
Laugh all you want! You won't be laughing tomorrow! No, wait. You will. Oh, never mind. Hi. Sorry I'm late.
The real reason I called both of you here again tonight is to...
Remember, Esther, you never need to be afraid to do what's right.
Your Highness, someone is plotting against my family. Tomorrow, my people and I will be banished to the island of Perpetual Tickling.
What? Banish my queen? Well, who would dare?
It's Haman.
Is this true?
I don't know what she's talking about. She's crazy.
It is true.
Can you prove this charge?
I'm telling you, she's making it up.
Wait a minute. Well, that's Mordecai. I just gave him a parade.
Mordecai is my cousin. His family is my family.
You had me banish the man who saved my life and my own queen? For your punishment, Haman, you ought to be sent to the island of Perpetual Tickling along with anyone else who dares scheme against my queen and her family.
So Haman got what was coming to him, and then some. And Mordecai, this is my favorite part, he got Haman's old job, the number two guy in the whole kingdom. Not bad. And Esther, what a gal. She showed more courage than 10 kings and saved her people. Now, she wasn't born for greatness. She didn't go to school for it. She just learned that sometimes God has plans so big only he can see him. All she had to do was believe. Yup, she was just a regular kid. Just like you.
Hi, Larry here, and you're listening to the story of Minnesota Cute.
Minnesota. The satellite imagery is pretty fuzzy. I'm getting a glare. Use your cap to shield the screen.
Martin, it's not a cap. It's called a fedora.
You just keep a sharp eye out. This is an important find for the Children's Museum.
Martin?
Yeah?
Is there anyone else up here?
No. That mountain is totally uninhabited. Hey, Minnesota, I think I found something. Look over by the rock to your left. You see anything?
I'm on it. The golden carrot nose of the indomitable snowman of the north. No worries.
Oh, but Minnesota, I forgot to mention something.
Professor Rattan!
Once again, Mr. Cucumber! Finders keepers!
Minnesota, I forgot to tell you, be careful! The snowman might be a little unstable.
I had it, Martin. The golden nose of the indomitable snowman of the north was in my hands.
It's okay, Minnesota. You did your best.
Then he was there.
Forget about Professor Rattan. Our children's museum will be fine. We'll get some stuff for the display soon.
He's taken away all my greatest finds ever since the second grade. Remember when he took Salvador's dolly? That hurt. And just to sell it on the internet.
Rattan's just a big bully, Minnesota. You have to ignore his type and go on with your life.
It all started when he switched the gummy worms in my lunch with it.
I know, real worms.
But I didn't find out till after I ate them. As long as that bully is out there, I'm not searching for anything again. I'm staying right here.
Mr. Cucumber.
Yeah?
I'm with the New York Parks and Recreation Department, and I have an emergency with which only you can help.
Talk to the tomato. I don't go out anymore.
Just give him some space. What seems to be the trouble?
We at the NYPNRD believe that a rogue Canadian group of barrel makers have launched an attempt to take both sides of Niagara Falls.
Both sides? But they have the best side already.
I thought you were sulking.
Dastardly, isn't it?
Well, how can they do this?
Oh, they can't yet. They aren't strong enough. But their leader is looking for an item that will empower them beyond belief.
I thought other Canadians liked us.
What are these barrel makers looking for?
They are searching for none other than the legendary hairbrush of Samson.
You're kidding! The Samson?
What? Who's Samson?
Who's Samson? Samson was none other than the strong man in the Bible. God used him to fight against the Philistines who were bullying the Israelites.
A strong man that fought bullies, huh?
Didn't you ever go to Sunday school?
Well, what's the deal with the hairbrush?
Well, the story goes that Samson's amazing strength came from his long hair.
Well, kinda. It was really...
And when Samson's hair was cut, he lost his strength. This hairbrush is believed to be the very same that was used during the infamous shearing. So these rogue Canadians believe that whoever has possession of the brush will also gain Samson's amazing power.
But if I find the brush first, I'll have the power. Then, I can stop Rattan from bullying everybody.
Be careful, Minnesota. This isn't a chance to try to get even with Rattan, you know. It's more important than that.
It would be a lovely addition for your children's museum. You are our last hope, Mr. Cuke.
I may have blown the nose caper, but this time, I'll have the goods on Professor Rattan. I'll go.
But Minnesota, where are you gonna start?
There's only one person who would know about a brush this important.
But Min, she isn't an archaeologist anymore. She gave it up when...
Martin, I'm going out for ice cream. Hello, Julia.
Minnesota Cuke. I always knew that someday you'd come walking through my door.
It's been a long time. Look, I need a couple things from you, Julia. First, a chocolate Malta.
Malt.
Right, chocolate.
No, it's malt, not Malta.
What?
Malt is a dessert, Malta is an island.
But with an Italian accent, they're both the same. I'm looking for clues, Jules.
You're not the clueless type.
I'm on the trail of a hairbrush.
Same song, second verse.
It's a special brush. Belonged to a fella goes by the name of Samson. You heard of it?
I've heard there are a lot of guys after this brush. It's too dangerous, Cuke. Stay out of it.
And let those Canadians take over? No way. Somebody's got to stand up for the little guy.
You're asking for trouble, Cuke. All right. Try this address. 206 Via de Cortes de Pelo. There's some fellas there who might help.
I knew I can count on you.
Yo, Cuke. You forgot your malt.
I didn't order it for me.
You need something to go, Cuke? Oh, what'll it be, sir?
I'll have what your friend was having. The address, please.
I'll never tell you.
Oh, I think you will.
Okay, Martin, I got an address. 206 Via de Cortes de Pelo.
I'm on it. And I have more information about Samson for you.
Spill it.
Well, God wanted Samson to be extra special, so Samson had to make certain promises to God.
Promises?
Yeah, he couldn't touch dead things, eat grapes, or cut his hair.
That's weird.
But Samson didn't always keep his promises very well. You see, one day...
Okay, Martin, could you hurry this up? I need you to find that address for me.
But, Minnesota, there must be a mistake. I can't find that address anywhere in Malta.
Hmm, I must have got it wrong. I'll go back and check. You all right?
I didn't tell Cuke.
Didn't tell what?
There was a man. He wanted to know about the brush, but I didn't tell him anything.
The Canadians! We gotta find that address. Is it nearby?
Cuke, we're going to Seville.
Hey, Figaro. Cannot find my best razor. You been using my razor again?
Why I wanna use your razor, Leo? My razor suits me just fine.
I'm just a saying, I can't find my razor, and you the only other one here.
So you're positive that guy was Canadian?
I can't be sure. He didn't look Canadian.
Hey, buongiorno, mi amici. Have a seat right here. So sorry, senora. We only do the man's hair.
Leo?
Hey, Figaro. Look who's back. Hey, Leo, what do you know? Mia piccola farfalla. How you been, Julia? You been eating well? You look thin.
What's the matter, you? She looks great. Che bella, no?
Of course she looks so wonderful, you meatball. I only mean she's
look,
a...
Look, fellas. We came here to ask you about something.
No problemo, bambina. What you wanna know?
Hey, Pazan. I believe she's talking to me.
I never said
maybe this was a bad idea. Are you sure these are the guys I need to talk to?
Of course. Go ahead. Ask.
Gentlemen, I need to know about a hairbrush. Samson's hairbrush.
He's okay.
But fellas, I don't need a...
Remove his cap.
It's not a cap. It's a fedora.
You just sit down and listen to Figaro and Leo.
La spazola di Samson. The hairbrush of a Samson. She's not a drink to be trifled with, you know?
Maybe your girlfriend forget to tell you. Figaro and I are la fratellanza della spazola.
The brotherhood of the hairbrush.
For centuries, our papas and our papas' papas have protected the secret of the whereabouts of the brush.
We cannot let it fall into the wrong hands. Capiche?
Yeah, I capiche.
Why you want La Spazola di Samson?
I need to find the hairbrush before the Canadians do. They plan to use its power to take over both sides of Niagara Falls.
Mamma mia, no!
Well, don't you worry, my friend. The hairbrush is somewhere safe where nobody but nobody will ever, ever find her.
Where?
Down, down, down. Underneath the city. There are secret catacombs.
Catcombs? I'm not looking for a comb. It's a
No, not catacombs. Catacombs!
And down in these ancient catacombs, there is a secret chamber.
And in the secret chamber lies the one and only Spazola di Samson.
See, Samson's a hairbrush. She lies safe.
But what if somebody finds the catacombs?
Nobody can find the catacombs, silly mozzarella. Not without this map.
Cuke, it's him!
Nobody follows me, understand? Especially you, Minnesota fluke! Once again, you lose, worm eater!
Let me out of the chair! Hey, Figaro! Figaro! Figaro!
Figaro! Mamma mia!
He's gonna get the hairbrush first. I gotta call Martin. Martin? Martin?
I'm here, Cuke. What's wrong? Did you get a haircut?
Never mind that. Where's the park guy?
Huh? He was here a second ago. I guess he slipped out. Tell me, what's going on?
Good, he wouldn't want to hear this anyway. It's bad news, Martin.
Would you just tell me already?
He was here, Martin. And he's after the brush.
Who?
Professor Rattan.
Okay, now don't panic, Minnesota. Remember, he's a bully. We can deal with him.
Just a bully? He's more than that. He's my enemy!
Calm down. The Bible says we should love our enemies.
Love? Love our enemies?
Everybody can't go around all the time trying to get even. That would leave the whole world in a mess. Let's just figure out what to do next.
I'll tell you what we're gonna do, Martin. I'm gonna get that brush first, and I'm gonna use its power to defeat all the bullies in the world. I'm gonna teach them a lesson they'll never forget.
But Minnesota!
See you in the funny papers, Martin. All right. Where are those catacombs?
I'm glad you ask.
We have a shortcut.
Let's go.
Too dangerous, Jules. I gotta go alone.
Be careful, Cuke.
It's the story of Samson. I'm on the right trail. What a guy. What's this all about? Samson lost his strength after a haircut? Poor fella.
Mr. Cuke?
Professor Rattan!
Make this simple, Mr. Cuke. Please, hand over the hairbrush.
Why would I do that? I have the brush. I have the power.
Really?
Of course. Watch.
What's wrong? You have no hair.
What?
You have no power because you have no hair.
But...
Now, please, Mr. Cuke, if you will just hand over the brush.
Never, Rattan. I won't give it to you, or the Canadians, or anybody. It's mine.
Oh, but I think you will.
Cuke! Julia! Mr. Parkman! You saved Julia! Thank you! I didn't know
that... Oh, no, Minnesota. He works for me. You see, it was you, Minnesota, who told me the address of the barbershop, and you who led us straight to the brush! It's a simple trade, Minnesota. The brush for the girl.
Don't do it, Cuke.
Trade. Get away with this, Rattan!
Everyone says that, but I always do. Goodbye!
We have to stop him!
Why?
Because he's a bully, Jules. I gotta get even with him. Why, if it's the last thing I do, I'll track him down and repay him for every time he's been mean to me.
You've changed, Cuke. You don't care about the hairbrush anymore. Now you only want to get even. I don't like that in you, Cuke. You're nothing but a bully.
Julia, I'm sorry. You're right, Julia. Being mean back to a bully just makes me a bully too. But it's too late now. I can't do anything. That you, Martin?
Cuke! Cuke! I've been trying to get a hold of you! You'll never guess!
The park guy isn't from New York. He's really working for Professor Rattan, who's been following me this whole time. And I don't think there really is a rogue band of Canadian barrel makers. They made that whole thing up to trick me. Now Rattan can rule the world because he's got all the power.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, no. Cuke, that's what I've been trying to tell you. The brush doesn't have any power.
But the Bible said that Samson's hair was his...
The Bible said that God gave Samson his power, not his hair or his hairbrush.
But what about the haircut that made him lose his strength?
That wasn't about his hair, Min. Samson lost his strength because he didn't keep his promise to God. And the best part is that God gives us strength, too.
What?
Yep. He gives us an even greater power than Samson's, the power to love our enemies and even be kind to them.
This isn't gonna be easy, but I know what I gotta do. Ready?
You bet.
Hold it right there, Rattan.
What? How did... I have a brush, and I know how to use it!
You think he's crazy enough to try something?
You betcha.
Canadians!
No, 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 my friend. They're good guys. We call it the cavalry.
Yeah! Nobody comes to the rescue better than the Royal Canadian Mounties, eh? Get him!
Ha! There's nothing you can do against the power of Samson's hairbrush!
But it has no power.
You know nothing! Of course it has power! Watch!
It doesn't work.
What's wrong?
Check the batteries, perhaps?
Doesn't have any power. Never has.
Just you wait. I'll be back.
Wait. Why are you taking him away?
Well, because
he stole a hairbrush.
He stole a hairbrush, eh?
No, he didn't. I traded him for it.
You mean...
Yep, you can let him go.
Now's our chance. Let's go. No, wait. This doesn't make sense. No one has ever been kind to me. Why did you do that?
Because God gives us the power to love everybody, even our enemies. Here, you drop this.
I don't think I want it after all.
Sure you do. Look, you can use it to cover up that little bald spot you're getting.
Ooh, nice.
Hey, I'm sorry for everything I've done. I think I'm gonna like being friends.
What an adventure! And Professor Rattan let you keep the hairbrush after all!
Well, he didn't need it since he gave up that whole world domination thing.
I'm just glad it all worked out.
You know, Cuke, I never got to tell you.
What's that, Jules?
I'm real proud of the way you handled that bully.
Aw, Julia.
Moose Lake Children's Museum. Yes? What? It is? Sounds dangerous. Well, let me ask him. Hey, Cuke, think you can find Noah's umbrella?
Where's my cap?
It's called a fedora.